Arjen Robben announced his retirement from professional football for a second time on the 15th of July 2021, hanging up his boots following a brief return to football with his first club, FC Groningen. Robben's retirement brought an end to the career of one of Dutch football's finest modern talents, a footballer who scaled huge heights and played the game with a devastating simplicity that proved impossible to stop. Robben's career began in his native Netherlands with the aforementioned FC Groningen, coming through the club's academy ranks as a wiry-framed winger, making his debut as a 16-year-old in the Dutch Eredivisie. The raw attributes that defined Robben's career were swiftly evident as he made 18 appearances during that maiden campaign in 2000-2001, scintillating speed tormenting opposition fullbacks. The following season saw the youngster score 6 goals to help Groningen avoid relegation to the Netherlands' second tier, and predictable interest from further up the division soon arrived, with the young professional accepting a move to PSV and enjoying immediate success in the Dutch city of Eindhoven, forming a brilliant partnership with Serbia international Mateja Kesman that became affectionately nicknamed Batman and Robben. The winger scored 12 goals and provided 7 assists as PSV reclaimed the league title from Ajax in 2003, with Robben appropriately being named as Eredivisie's best player aged under 21. His second season, however, proved less successful as the injury problems that plagued much of his career began to surface, but the dynamic Dutchman was already being tipped for bigger things as England's elite began to show interest. Manchester United and Sir Alex Ferguson held talks with the teenager over a move to the Premier League, but as the Red Devils stalled over the player's price tag, big spending rivals Chelsea moved swiftly to secure Robben's signature. Speaking with 442 years later, this is what Robben said about the interest from United. "I had a very good conversation with the manager over dinner in Manchester and we spoke about football and life. I also went and had a good look around the training ground and everything was good, but after I went back to PSV, nothing happened. There was no real contact and the deal didn't happen. PSV were also negotiating with Chelsea at that time, so maybe they offered PSV more money. I don't really know. I spoke to Chelsea and I liked their plans. We had one meeting and everything was done pretty quickly. Had United offered me a deal straight after I met them, I would have signed there, but it didn't happen and I have no regrets." Chelsea's fortunes had been transformed by the billionaire takeover of Russian oligarch Roman Abramovich a year earlier, with Robben arriving in the summer of 2004 as part of a recruitment drive under new manager Jose Mourinho. A broken metatarsal in pre-season stalled his start at Stamford Bridge, but after returning to the side in October, he began to star as Mourinho shifted away from English football traditions of a 4-4-2 system. With Robben and Damien Duff operating either side of lone forward Didier Drogba, Chelsea cruised to a first league title in 50 years, losing just one Premier League fixture as a new era of success was ushered in West London. Robben would score 7 goals and provide 9 assists to be named in the PFA Team of the Year before impressing once again as back-to-back league titles were secured in 2006. His third season proved a frustrating campaign despite a domestic cup double, scoring just 2 league goals in a stop-start campaign for the Blues. Despite those frustrations, it came as a surprise given the player's potential and performances when Chelsea accepted a fairly modest £24 million bid from European titans Real Madrid, with the Dutchman jetting to Spain. After a slow start in sunny Madrid, Robben grew in importance as Los Blancos secured the La Liga title in 2007-2008, before scoring 8 goals in all competitions during an impressive second season in Spanish football. However, Florentino Perez's return as club president in 2009 led to a second wave of the Galactico recruitment policy, presenting the summer signings of Portuguese Cristiano Ronaldo, Brazilian Kaká, Frenchman Karim Benzema, and Spanish Xabi Alonso, with Robben's future in the Spanish capital hanging in a balance. When the inevitable departure came, Robben admitted he didn't want to leave and cited the club's desire to sell him as the key reason for his exit. Definitely at the time, Robben might have been slightly disappointed to swap Real Madrid for Bayern Munich, even if there's barely a smidge separating the two clubs' stature, but there's no doubting that the switch had to happen for Robben to cement his place as one of the modern greats. After all, he had picked up 4 league titles in his time with PSV, Chelsea, and Real Madrid, but the ultimate prize, the Champions League, proved elusive. Real's loss most certainly proved to be Bayern Munich's gain after the winger completed a €25 million move to the German Bundesliga, persuaded to take the step following positive talks with compatriots Marc van Bommel and manager Louis van Gaal. His debut season in 09-10 proved the most productive of his career as he was named Germany's Footballer of the Year, scoring 23 goals in all competitions as Bayern secured a domestic double. Robben's success was intertwined with heartbreaking losses, however, as Bayern were denied the chance of a historic treble after losing to Inter Milan in the 2010 Champions League final, whilst further agony followed after the Netherlands' World Cup final defeat to Spain that summer. Despite league rivals Borussia Dortmund's emergence as Germany's dominant force over the next 2 seasons, Robben continued to go from strength to strength as the dynamic Dutchman formed one half of a devastating duo alongside fellow winger Frenchman Franck Ribéry. In an era where inverted wingers truly began to thrive, the pairing flourished in Bavaria as they drifted inside to cause chaos against Bundesliga defenses. Robben's game was one comprised of such sublime simplicity, his utter and complete one-footedness leading to a repetition of the winger cutting inside and taking sight of goal. A lack of diversity in a footballer's game would more frequently lead to being found out at the highest level, but Robben's ability to be monotonous and still manage to be spectacular was the mastering of a movement that left defenders confused. There proved to be more heartache for the rampaging Dutchman before he truly reached his pinnacle, a missed extra-time penalty in the 2012 Champions League final proving costly as Bayern were defeated by his former side Chelsea at their own Allianz Arena, crowned Kings of Europe for the first time in the Blues' history. Bayern would bounce back the following season in some style, however, as Jupp Heynckes' side swept all before them to win a domestic double and reach a second successive Champions League final. Robben had been plagued by familiar fitness issues during the opening months of the 2012-2013 campaign, but returned to inspire Bayern's passage to the showpiece tournament, scoring in both legs of a 7-0 semi-final distraction of Barcelona. Dortmund awaited in the first ever all-German final meeting, though it was Robben and Bayern who were left celebrating as their Dutch winger produced arguably his most iconic moments. With seconds remaining at Wembley Stadium as extra time loomed and the scores level at 1-1, Robben burst into the box to collect Ribéry's backheel pass and rolled a dramatic late winner beyond Dortmund's goalkeeper Roman Weidenfeld. Euphoria ensued as the winger wheeled away to celebrate in front of the raucous Bayern support behind the goal, this marking Robben's redemption and a moment that crowned Bayern champions of Europe for the 5th time in their storied history. The following campaign saw Robben hit a career best of 17 league goals as Bayern embarked on a period of unprecedented dominance in Germany, winning each of the next 6 Bundesliga titles in succession. For a player whose career was riddled with niggles and knocks, it's a testament to Robben that his career contained such longevity, remaining a key component of the German side until his exit in 2019. He departed the Allianz Arena as one of the club's modern legends, having scored a total of 144 goals in 309 appearances and won 8 league titles, 5 DFB Pokal trophies, and the Champions League amongst his honours. A romantic return to his childhood club Groningen ultimately led to more time on the treatment table before eventually hanging up his boots for good, waving goodbye to the sport as a title winner in four countries and as one of the Netherlands' all-time greats with 37 goals in 96 appearances at international level. His trademark cut-in-and-shoot maneuver, gleaming bald head, and stacked trophy cabinet will never ever be forgotten.